ito na naman po ako. Meron po ako isang magandang tatalakayin tungkol din po to sa mga karakteristik ng mga manok natin pinapalahian. Ito po ay tinatawag na strength and endurance. Kay Pinter Bush din po ito. Ito po siya, strength and endurance. Fighting puts a great strain upon muscles and nerves and is recognized as the most violent exertions the body can be put to. We have had the opportunity to witness several thousand fights, cats, dogs, men, and oddities. Some beings are natural fighters and go at it with aid, decided self-confidence, while other beings engage in a fight with all the signs of terror. One would believe that the latter are naturally cowards, but the error may be noticed when the whining dog or nervous man engages in a terrible fight and behaves up to the highest standard. The nervosity prior to warming up is due to a mental disposition and the effect of late or defective gland segregation. Nervosity in any fighter is a heavy fault, and a specimen that afflicted should never be used as breeders. This is especially the case with game fowl, as nervous cocks are acting under the stress of impaired mentality and prone to run at the slightest notice. Such cocks stage a comeback and may surprise their antagonist with a furious attack. Wheelers have been developed from such stock, and though many cockers fancy this stratagem where are opposed to any cock that resorts to such tricks, nervosity should not be mistaken for anxiety. A top high spirited cock, especially if experienced in the ring, may feel anxious to fight at once when he notices the presence of any antagonist. The nervous cock, however strong and rugged be may appear, in prone to fail and go down after some backers, particularly when injured. This brings us to the source of strength and endurance. The unity of power in the accumulation of same is strength. Bones and muscle are intimately related in their proportion and easily detected by handling. In a well-balanced cock, the relative amount of muscle and bone may be detected with a glance and shanks and head, which generally are in equilibrium with the rest of the body. Endurance is the power of maintaining the initial energy for a given length of time. It is strongly related to gameness, which is the power of using endurance up to the limit. As such, endurance is of nervous character and derived from glandular segregation. When the latter fails, endurance become lost. It stands to reason that however strong a cock may be, he is usually poor if his muscular wealth is not properly backed by endurance. The latter must consequently be a matter of very careful consideration in the selection of breeding stock. Sparring cocks with small mops or gloves, or testing them with corked short gaps will generally show the degree of endurance and energy of your stock. Muscular sufficiency, energy, health, and alertness constitute what is known as physical vigor, and is the source of strength and endurance. It is produced by nervous and glandular function, which normally are inherited factors but are preserved by correct keeping and feeding methods. It stands to reason that when such quality has been inherited, it must be improved by giving the youngster the best chance to bring physical vigor to the highest state. Adverse condition in youth will materially alter vigor, and any sort of disease may impair it seriously, acting upon the nerve centers and consequently upon the glandular system. We may say that as the muscle is the unity of strength, the gland is the unity of health, each of which constitutes an individual organ, functions makes the organ. Exercise, therefore, absolutely necessary for the proper muscle development, hence the necessity of providing scratching sheds and country walks. Nerves and muscles are developed in their highest possibility of constant function. Free runs in the field with no disturbance and preoccupation will have the beneficial effect upon the nervous system that stands for endurance. A kupkak, constantly frightened and worried by hundreds of impressions that make him feel the confinement, in which we cannot judge from our human point of view, will seldom, if ever, grow to perfection. Coop walking requires a lot of care and judgment that can be avoided by country walking. A lazy life in confinement will never make a good cop. If you observe the individual muscle as unity of power, we must admire the strain it can support in the laboratory. In actual practice, a muscle is seldom used up to the limit of its capacity. And when this is done, it may be the cause of a collapse or a sprain. Wing muscles are governed and move differently from those of the leg. This is a fact deducted from the effect this motion should have. The exertions of the wings are break by the resistance of the feathers against the air, while those of the legs are not break at all if they miss the target. The movement of the leg is a punch and should naturally come to a stop as soon as the point of application. The spar hits in the third body. The function of both members, wing and leg, are different. The movement, however, is affected. Muscles which are very much alike but which differ widely in their nervous control, the proportion of energy bestowed on either wings or leg constitute the profound difference between primarily flyers, bankiba, and runners, malays, and the nervous disposition of both constitute their intrinsic character. Punch is the power, velocity, and weight behind the spar in the movement of finding resistance. If a cock will cut slowly, velocity and weight will be naturally absent. It is tolerably sure that even a sharp spar will not cut through hard muscle under such condition. Punch, then, is necessary, and the sum of power, weight, and speed. It is commanded by nervous exertion. Its intensity can be truly abnormal, as we have witnessed in some cocks capable of breaking wood boards with a single blow that would have required hatchet. This performance of the nerve is known as tension, and cocks under the effect of same have been known to be killed instantly by a single blow. It is the more remarkable as when a foul quite a while, yet in the pit, many a cock is killed instantly. the sum of muscular and nervous capacity, the power of serving out forceful punches, and the capacity of doing this incessantly in the physical perfection known as strength and endurance. Okay.